Is my dad there? Is it,
Mick.
Mick, do you,
the Grave Street Brigade.
Did you say something about Tommy Potts before when I get a bit of rosin or something?
Next door, isn't it?
They were the family of the honour. Mick the person of the Grave
Street. It's a portrait there, it's a photograph, and I remember that was taken through to college as a... all the mighty men were on stage, John Joe Gardner and John Kelly. John was positive of music, and but Tommy was from here. He was born on the Coomb, just down the street here, and his father was a great piper and a highly respected man. People came to his house, and Tommy was very much influenced by him, but he wasn't satisfied just to play the tune and to get through it like most of us did without going into a wobble. He had to do something with us, and he was very reflective on what he played, and there was so much in it, and it's very complex and overlaid, and he was a complex man himself, but he was very modest and he was very religious, and he felt he was doing it all for a higher being. But he was a very entertaining man and very respectful to other people. And I remember him coming home from the club, walking up Breed Street, and he talking to me about Jaffa Hyphus and all these great violinists. And he assumed I knew about them, but I hadn't heard most of them. I had to go home and find out who they were. That's the type of, he didn't talk down to you. He was giving you the benefit of the doubt. But he was aware of these people, and he was interested in the tonality of the music and their instruments. And so he was a man ahead of his time. And here, take away the money.
Thank you. It is. I just wanted to say one or two small things. Over the past 50 years or so, people listening to traditional Irish music have got used to formulaic music, especially that played by accordion players. And a numbness has fallen over our music over this past two or three decades. I wanted to invite all of you whom I love here to lift my heart after 6 months in India. Yeah.